Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, people of God. Hallelujah.
God, you said that in the last days.
Yes, God.
You shall quiet the spirit of one on.
That's it.
You said that the young people shall prophesy.
Hallelujah.
And
good
God,
morning,
the young
Jasmine.
People need you like nothing before.
Yes, God.
When the enemy is on attack. So now, God, I pray against all type of dark bodies.
Hallelujah. Yes, God, come on. Gather your children this morning. I turn it on the Bluetooth if you are not one who normally does that, because today we're talking to the young ones. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God, hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, I bless your name. Yes. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Thank you, Lord. Yes, God. Get your kiddos, and if you're watching the replay on YouTube, definitely sit down, get a group of kids, and sit down and let this lesson bless them. Pop some popcorn. Come on, have movie night, and let's watch the Word of God together. Hallelujah. Good morning, Demetrius. Good morning, Heaven. Good morning, Bishop. Those are my little ones. Good morning, Ashara. Good morning, Andrew. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning, Jacob. Good morning, Janae. Good morning, Jade. Hallelujah. Good morning, Jamaj. Good morning, Cadence. Good morning, let me see. Trying to get all these names together, y'all. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Good morning, Serenity. Good morning, Chase. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. Ooh, glory. Yes, God. We're going to have us a good day today. All the kiddos today that's going to school, you're going to have a good day. You're going to make good choices and good decisions. I used to tell my kids that. Amen. Good morning, Acadius. And Jarius and Kalan. Hallelujah. Good morning. Good morning, everybody tuning in from all over. Good morning, Detroit. Hallelujah. Yes. Woo, glory. I just believe God is doing something in our children, y'all. My God. Woo. Come on. Hallelujah. God, I bless your name. We're talking to the young people on today. There is a word from the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I will be the one. Yay, glory. We're making that declaration at a young age. God, I bless your name. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Yes, God, I bless your name. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Woo, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning, Rachel. Good to see you this morning, woman of God. Hallelujah. Listen, there is a word from the Lord on today. Hallelujah. There is a word from the Lord. Good morning, Misty. Hallelujah. Good morning to your girls. I don't have their name in front of me. I'm excited. We're talking to the young folks today, the little ones all the way up. All right. Hallelujah. This is one of my favorite songs. This is called I Fight For You by Molly Music. It blesses me when I start thinking about my children. Listen, we as parents, we got to learn how to fight. We got to fast. We got to pray. And we got to live righteous. Yes, God. I know that life is trying to get you. I know that life is calling out to you by your name, but don't listen. Good morning, Jeff. Good to see you this morning. Remember where you came from. What you got is amazing. Hold that. You hold the light. You hold the light. You hold the light and it's shining, making darker places brighter and lighter. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Yes, God. but it's not for the taking. It's not for no, it's not for remixing. It's not for remaking. All right. Hallelujah. Woo, glory. We touch and agree with the prayer requests that are coming in this morning. Hallelujah. You know, I do drop a couple of bars. I ain't gonna drop none this morning, but I do drop a couple of bars here and there. I fight for you. Yeah, this is my song for my children, baby. Glory. Hallelujah. Yes, God, I fight for you. Because I refuse to lose you. Let's get that together. Yes, God. Come on. Jesus didn't play about the babies, and I don't either. We don't play about the babies in Makeova Transformation Church. Hallelujah. My God. Woo! This song was called Fight For You by Molly Music. My walk is slow to speaking. Y'all know, like, sometimes we go in at my house on Friday nights. When I got a whole bunch of young people around me, we get in the car, we put the sunroof down, we turn on the good old the gospel rap, and we go in. We ride around the city and we bless God. Whee! Glory. I don't know who said serving God was boring, not in my house. Whee! Come on. It's not for remaking, all right. My God. That's it. Okay. The little man of God's on her preaching. That's it. Whee! The devil get dizzy when you fight. That's right. I won't let him take you. Yee. As parents, we got to be their protection. We can't keep leaving the door open to the enemy. My God, come on. We got to live a righteous life on purpose. Yee. Glory. Come on. We got to slay some of them giants before they hit our kids. Come on. Hallelujah. We got to even give them some new music to listen to. Come on. If they like rap music, you got to find something that's good.
There's no need to worry about them. Let me
come on. God is a good God, y'all. Hallelujah. Good morning, everybody that's tuning in on today. Yes, God. That's it. Okay, Mama Bear Ministry. Exactly. That's what my spiritual daughter calls me. So I know you right. It's called Molly Music by it's called Fight For You by Molly Music. Woo! To us, you're perfect. I'm here on purpose. Yes, God. Okay, we fight for them by teaching them the righteousness of Christ. Come on. We don't even have to fight all their battles for them. God, I bless your name because they have a heavenly Father. My God, but if we just teach them, we train them up in the way that they shall go. Hallelujah. Yes, God. I love the Lord. He's a good God, y'all. He's a good God. Come on. Woo. Yes, God. The Lord is a good God, y'all. I just want the kids to know. I don't know who's what we've been taught, but it's a blessing to serve God. Okay? It's a blessing to serve God. Hallelujah. Lord, we just thank you for all the young people on today, God. We just thank you, Lord, that you are able to do all things, God. We thank you that you are able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above, more than we can think, ask, or imagine. God, I ask that you touch every young person that tunes in today, every young person from in the womb, even if the mama's pregnant. All the way up, God. I thank you that you are able to do all things. God, we ask that you cover them under the blood. Give them a hunger for righteousness. Give them a hunger for holiness. God, don't let them be comfortable outside of your will. Don't let them be comfortable outside of your way, oh great God. Lord, we ask that you just touch them on today, God. Keep them safe from hurt, harm, danger, pain, and trouble. And when the enemy comes in like a flood, Lord, we thank you that your word already declares that you will raise up a standard. God, we thank you that those situations will arise in their life, God. We thank you, God. We bless your name. We thank you that they already have a word secured over their head, that no weapon formed against them shall prosper, and every tongue that rises up shall be condemned. God, I ask that you touch them on today. Allow boldness to hit their hearts today, God. Allow boldness, a fresh boldness to hit them on today, God. The power of the Holy Ghost. God, I thank you. May they be filled on today. Glory. May they be empowered to do what honors you and what pleases you. God, I bless your name. May they be able to go into the schools and they don't have to be afraid of no bully, baby, because what they pack in, the same power that raised Christ Jesus from the dead, it lives in them, my God. Help them to understand that you are their source, you are their exceeding great reward, that angels walk with them, and that if you be for them, you are greater than the world against them. Touch them on today, God. Anoint their ears to hear the word of God, and their minds to accept the word of God, and their hearts to receive the word of God. Lord, we thank you, we bless you, we honor you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah and amen. Woo, glory. Listen, get your kids in the room today. Hey, glory, come on. If you are watching the replay, hallelujah, that's a blessing. I'm excited. Make sure you get you some kids, order some pizza, some popcorn, sit around the TV, and bring the kids in. This is what we have to do, okay? The same way we have movie night and we watch Jurassic Park and Spider-Man and whatever else things we watch, and we have to get the word of God in their souls, because that's the only thing that's going to keep them, because you're not going to be here always. I'm not going to be here always. I tell my kids all the time, baby, I'm limited. I'm limited. I'm just mama. I'm limited. Hey, glory. Glory. I'm just mama. We have to teach them to cut the middleman out at a young age. Hey, glory. Teach them to cut that middleman out. My God, come on. Woo, glory. And then you'll get to a place, my mama tell me all the time, she said, you just really don't call me for that much. I said, mama, because I love you, but I learned to cut the middleman out. I got to take it to God. Hey, glory. God, I bless your name. Come on. The Lord is so good. He is so kind. He is amazing. Mighty are the works of his hand. Our word today is, don't say you're too young. Don't say you're too young. No. My God, don't say you're too young. Hallelujah. See, the thing that's so beautiful is that the enemy can't have all the young kids. He can't have all the young kids. And so we have to teach them their heritage. I truly believe in that here at the Makeova Ministry. All right, let's hop into our word on today. Let's hop into our word on today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This song is called Give Me. And it's by Kirk Franklin featuring Molly Music. So that's another one that's really good that blesses me. Ooh, glory. God is so good, y'all. Good morning, Julie. It's good to see you this morning. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Amen. No, we ain't giving up. Come on, we holding tight. Somebody said, let me see what that comment was. You said you can't. You can't give up now. No, we ain't giving up now. Come on. Put your boxing gloves back on. Lay, I'm about to make me put on my army fatigues. I feel like one of my fatigues this morning. Woo! Woo, God is faithful. Okay. Don't say I'm too young. Don't say I'm too young. We want to teach our children that they have a heritage. You don't have to wait till you get old to serve God. This is about to bless us. Get your word of God on today, and we're going to go to 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles, okay? 2 Chronicles, and we're going to start at verse 34, all right? Now, if you are watching this with young people, right, it's morning, so I know y'all getting ready for school. But when you catch the replay, sit down and let them read the word of God. Let them see the words on the page. It's something about when you get that in your spirit and you see it with your own eyes. It's not what mama told you. It's what you read for yourself. Give me that power to walk away when another God wants to take your place. That is the best part of that song for me. Give me that power to walk away when another God wants to take your place. My God, come on. That part of the song, I don't know about that. That part right there blesses me because we're just in a place. Sin has always been rampant, but it just keeps getting worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. Give me that power, hey, glory, to walk away when another guy wants to take your place, when sin wants to come in, when my friends are doing all the wrong things, when my mind is telling me get up and run around the classroom, when my mind is telling me talk back to my mama. Give me the power, hey, of self-control to hold it together. God, I bless your name. Give me the power to not respond when people talk crazy, when they speak all matter of ill against me. My God, come on. Ooh, help us, Holy Ghost. The Lord is so good, y'all. We're getting in our word today. Let me pause this one because I'll pull this back up. This is called Lay My Life Down. This is by Tasha Page. This is one of my really good friends. And it's a blessed song. Please make sure you look it up on YouTube. It's called Lay My Life Down by Tasha Page. It'll bless you. It's another really great one. All right. This story in the Bible is really amazing. All right, let me pause the music. Okay, so 2 Chronicles 34 in verse 1 is where we're getting ready to start, okay? 2 Chronicles 31 in verse 4. 2 Chronicles 34 in verse 1. Josiah was 8 years old. Wait a minute, how? Josiah was 8 years old. Do I got anybody that's 8 years old? Come on in the room. Josiah was 8 years old when he became king and he reigned. That means he was the king in Jerusalem 31 years. He did what was pleasing in the Lord's sight and he followed the example of his ancestor David. So he was 8 years old. And not only was he 8 years old, he was allowed to be the king. He was the king for 31 years. And while he was the king, he did what pleased God. He did what was honorable to God. That's a whole blessing. He followed the example of those that have went before him that also did what was pleasing to God. Okay. He did not turn away from doing what was right, because so often that's what a lot of people do. They start out on the good path. We can see it in Hollywood all day, every day. We can see it. We start out on a good path, and they start out even in music, you know, music or whatever. We can start out and this music seems so harmless, but then we get to a place where we turn. We no longer do what pleases God. Even those of you who are like maybe you was raised in church and you love the Lord and you was good, you was a Sunday school baby and now you grew all the way up. But then when you get to high school, that's where a lot of people turn. Nowadays, middle school people are turning. We're turning to drugs and turning to all of these things, having sex and all these things that are not what pleases God, not what pleases your mom and not what pleases your dad. Verse 3, during the 8th year of his reign, while he was still young, Josiah began to seek the God of his ancestor David. So at 8 years old, he became king and he just followed the example. That's what it looks like when you just go to church because your mama tell you to go to church. You read your Bible because your mama told you to read your Bible. But the word of God says that while he was still young in the 8th year, meaning when he was 16 years old, he began to seek a personal relationship for himself. So now nobody had to tell him to get his Bible. He woke up by himself in the morning and read his word. He woke up by himself and turned on music that was pleasing to God and not music that was not pleasing to God. Okay. During the 8th year of his reign, while he was still young, Josiah began to seek the God of his ancestor David. Then in the 12th year, he began to purify Judah and Jerusalem, destroying all the pagan shrines and the Ashtar poles and the carved idols and cast images. So now in the 12th year, he began to purify. So at the age of 20, he now began to, first he did what was right because other people told him to do it. Then he began to seek God to understand what was right for himself. My God. And then at the age of 20, he began to tell other people. Now he began to be like, no, this ain't of God, because I read it in my word, because the Holy Spirit helped me understand it in my heart that was not right. Somebody's going to get free today. Somebody's child who has been struggling with rebellion is going to get free today just by hearing the word of God. Come on. The word of the Lord says, how can they know unless they hear? How can they hear unless a preacher speak? How can the preacher preach unless they be sent? Okay. And so we have to understand the word of God is not just, it's not just for when you get older. The word of God is for all ages. Hallelujah. Then in the 12th year, he began to purify Jerusalem and Judah and Jerusalem, destroying all the pagan shrines and the Ashtar poles and carved images and cast images. He began to look around and figure what things are not of God. Because some things are not of God. Ouija boards, that's not of God. Burning sage, that's not of God. Cutting yourself, that's not of God. God is not pleased with that. And so we have to understand when he began to see that these things are wrong, he began to get those things out of his life, out of his house, out of his room. He began to break up friendships because we can't be friends if you're doing all of that because I don't want to be led down the wrong path. I don't want to be associated with that. Okay. He ordered, verse 4, he ordered that the altar of Baal be demolished and that the incense altars which stood above them be broken down. He also made sure. He made sure. Okay. He took and he figured out what wasn't good. Now he has some rain. So now even let's talk about in the natural. So maybe now he's working at a job and he's been given a position to be a boss, to be a manager. Maybe he got his own company. Come on. He's looked at how other people have done it. And he said, no, that wasn't right. That's not right to be racist, being to hate white people or hate black people. That's not of God. Wait a minute. I might have seen my mama do it. I might have seen my daddy do it, but that's not of God. No, to smoke weed, that's not of God. No, to drink, that's not of God. No, I might have seen my grandma do it, and I might have seen my pawpaw do it, but that is not of God. And so he made sure to make sure that everything that he had access to, everything that he could speak over. See, you can't change your friend's life, but you can change yours. You don't have to, my fellas out there, you don't have to look at girls' butts and you don't have to be chasing nobody and touching nobody. You don't have to do those things. And my girls, you don't have to dress with all your stuff showing. No, that's personal. That's private. That's why it's called private parts. We got to keep it private. Come on. And so this is the beautiful part. Josiah was young. He was young. He was young. All his other friends could have been out doing all kind of crazy things. It's a blessing to serve God when you're young. You don't have to go to the nightclub. You don't have to be a teen mom. You don't have to be a teen father. Come on. You don't have to. I'm trying to help you understand because it's not that mama's being mean. It's not that daddy's being mean. It's not that grandma's being mean. Come on. It's not even that God is being mean. He's trying to keep us from things that don't go well in the long run. It might sound like a good idea today, but what is that going to cost me down the road? Okay, it might sound like a good idea today, but what is that going to cost me down the road? Okay, so we have to understand it's not that your parents are being mean. They don't want you. When they say go to bed so you can get your rest. Quit cutting up at school. It sounds like a good idea to be the class clown today. Make everybody laugh. But when you keep going through school and now your school record looks awful, and the teachers, they read on here and they trying to read about each student before you come in their classroom. And they already have made up their mind about you because your record goes before you. The word of God says, earn a good reputation with God and with people. And so even as a young person, it matters. I know a lot of people say, don't judge me. That's not true. The word of God says, examine yourself. You have to get to a place where you can have self-control. No matter how old you are, I don't care if you are 3, I don't care if you are 8, I don't care if you are 18, I don't care if you are 28. We have to learn to exercise self-control. You don't have to follow every voice in your head. Okay? Think about the last time that I did that, did it end well? The last time that I had a thought in my mind to get up and slap somebody upside the head, that wasn't good because now my mama's getting called and now I'm in the office and now when I get home, I got a problem because I'm going to have to deal with my mama because I'm not doing what is right. Okay? We got to understand that God puts rules in place not to hurt our heart, but he puts rules in place so that our life can be protected. Okay? So that our life can be protected and so that things can go good for us. You might not know what you want to be today, but things that we get into today, they can affect us years and years and years and years and years. I knew a guy who got in trouble, was smoking weed, got in a gang, got arrested at 16, and they let him off and got arrested again at 18, and then he had a felony on his record. And he went off to do some stuff. By the time he was 28, he was no longer in the gang. He was no longer running the streets. But whenever he went to go get things and try to get stuff in his name, now because of this felony on his record of things that he did when he was 16, somebody is hearing God today. Somebody is hearing God today. Somebody is right there. You're choosing to, which way am I going to go? Am I going to run with the streets? Am I going to run and rip with the streets? Am I going to hang out? Am I going to smoke weed? Am I going to get in the gang? Or am I going to be set apart and be lonely? Loneliness is only for a season. Okay. Loneliness is only for a season until you meet the next group of people. You have to be mindful. The world says birds of a feather flock together, whichever way you want to word it. But you don't want to be around people that are not making good choices and that are not making good decisions. Okay, young people. We're talking to our young people today. Everybody's welcome to listen. But today I have a special message for my young people. We're in 2 Chronicles 34. The word of God says King Josiah, he became king at 8 years old. When I read that, it was just like, wow, that is just so beautiful and amazing. Let's go to verse 5, he burned the bones of the pagan priests on their own altars, and so he purified Judah and Jerusalem. So he just made sure that everything that wasn't right, he settled the score. He got it straight. Come on, everything that was not good, he worked that. He's like, no, we're not going to do this. You're not going to sell drugs on my block. Come on. He by this time, he had gotten to a place where now he has some rank. Maybe he was an elected official. Maybe he was the president. Maybe he was over a community group. Maybe he was on the football team. Maybe he was in the NFL. No matter what the thing is that you're doing and that you aspire to do and you aspire to be when you get older, the thing that's so beautiful is you get to make decisions about the company that you keep. You get to make decisions about who gets to be in your inner circle. You get to make decisions, but I want you to examine, that means take a look at your friendships. Look at your friendships. Are they doing, even if you may say, well, this is my first time really listening to God or listening to a God sermon. I don't know what you're talking about, lady. Listen, this is the thing. Are they doing what is pleasing to their mom? Are they honoring their mother? Are they honoring their father? Are they doing what is right? Are they doing what is good when our teacher tells them to do something? Look at your friendships and see which direction are these friendships taking me. Okay, which direction are we going in? All right, let's we're gonna kind of skim through the text a little bit since we're reading with the young folks today. Verse 8, in the 18th year of his reign, he had purified the land and the temple. So he started when he was 8 by his the 18th year of his reign, which he was 26, I believe, making sure I'm getting my timeline together. He was 26 by this age. He had accomplished some things. You cannot accomplish what you're going to accomplish in life if you're just sitting down doing nothing, if you're sitting down being nothing, if you're being disrespectful to your parents and your teachers, if you've decided to smoke weed. Weed is not good. It makes you lazy. That's why you just want to sit around. And I got another one for us young folks. Listen, don't spend all your time on the video games. You're wasting precious moments. Don't spend all your time scrolling on TikTok. Don't spend all your time on Snapchat. What else are you gonna do? And this is another one. Don't spend all your time getting pretty. Okay, now you're pretty. You're spending 4 hours in the morning and getting on makeup and hair. We're wasting our days. Life and time is the most precious gift you have. I want you to be great. I want you to be wonderful. I want you to be amazing. Think about how you're using your time as young people. Think about how you're using your time. If you spend a whole 12 hours on a marathon, and these video games are set up and they are set up for you to lose. That's why they don't have what's it called? Like, it's not just you stop at the end. You can't stop because they want you to just keep, it's sucking up your time. You can't even stop and go to the bathroom because it's going to lose your place in the video game. I want us to see, may the Lord open your eyes this day. to see everything that you like that may be working against you in life. Everything that you think you like that may be working against you. Let's talk about getting tattoos, okay, people of God. Listen, we're not even going into whether it's right or whether it's wrong, but I need you to think about the things that you do to your body today. You may not want that in 5 years. And it might sound like a good idea to tattoo up your face and your neck and all of these things, but you're not going to want that in some years. I've got 5 tattoos. And who I was at 20 when I got them, 20, 21, 22, 23, when I got those tattoos, and who I am today, I wouldn't have gotten them. I want us to think about where we're going in life. Expose yourself to different people. Expose yourself to different friend groups, because you just never know. The career that's supposed to be for you, you may not be exposed to it in the circles that you're in. Sometimes you got to stretch outside your comfort zone. Okay. Let's go to verse 11. And we're in 2 Chronicles 34 and 11. They hired carpenters and builders who purchased finished stones for the walls and timber for the rafter and beams. So now they're building. Because now after this, after Josiah has now accomplished some things, he's gotten sin out of his life and all his friends. They now have realized, if we want to hang with Josiah, we can't drink and smoke and lie and cheat and steal. My God. So now your lifestyle begins to affect others. And now he's got some rank and some authority. So now he's able to talk to other people. Now he's a shot caller. Come on. There's a way to be a shot caller. There's a way to be famous. There is a way. It's not for smoking. It's not for having a whole bunch of girlfriends and having a whole bunch of boyfriends. That's not the way to do it. Come on. This is what is so beautiful. The next part of the scripture says, they restored what earlier kings of Judah had allowed to fall into ruins. Josiah was a part of being a life changer. Josiah and his friends and his people were a part of the word of God says they restored, they fixed what earlier kings, what your family of Judah had allowed to fail. Maybe everybody in your family still drinks and God has called you to not drink. And maybe your mama still drinks and maybe your daddy still drinks. But God has called you to get to a place where you're like, I don't want to spend all my money on alcohol. I've watched daddy spend all his money on weed. I've watched mama cheat. I've watched mama spend all her money on fashion shows. My God, but I can tell because that's my mama that her heart ain't happy, but she look pretty every day going out the door. Come on. I want you to examine. Take a look at, not so that you can tell your parents what to do, but take a look at your parents' life and see what things have they done excellent. And tell them thank you for those things. And then examine things that you feel that they can do better. You ain't got to tell them about those things, but I want you to take a look at those things. Maybe write it down in your journal. And then those are the things that you do better in your life on purpose. On purpose, you have to be intentional, especially if you can see those things in your mama's life, and then you look and you can see those things in your grandma's life, and you can see those things in her, and you can see those things in your daddy's life and in his daddy's life, and you decide you don't want that for your life. You got to be willing to do something different. They restored what earlier kings of Judah had allowed to fail. Some of you, the gift on your family is to be entrepreneurs, to be bosses, to have your own business. But everybody before you, they're still entrepreneurs, but they're dope dealers. Come on, that's not the way of God, but that gift is still in you to take a product, to sell it, and to make money. That's the gift of entrepreneurship, okay? We have to understand daily that God is teaching us stuff every day. Every day. Maybe you don't like how your mama cusses at you. Then don't start cussing because it's a bad habit. Maybe you don't like when your daddy lies to you. Then don't start lying because it's a bad habit. No condemnation, because without your mom and without your daddy, you wouldn't even be here. So even for those whose parents are not in their lives, and so you have a grudge in your heart and you're like, oh, well, if my mama was here and if my daddy was here, my life would be different. Not necessarily. Not necessarily. Be free today. Because without your mama, And without your daddy, no matter how crazy they are, no matter how wonderful they are, without them and all of daddy's DNA and all of mama's DNA, you wouldn't be your amazing, wonderful, beautiful, handsome self. Okay? So I want you to understand and take that into account. You're not too young to serve God. Let's go to Jeremiah. Jeremiah was another young man who the Lord used. And what's so amazing about Jeremiah was that when we read the word of God, the word of the Lord in Jeremiah 1 and 3 says, the Lord's message continued through the reign of King Jehoiakim, Josiah's son, until the 11th reign of Zadok. Now, the Lord began speaking through all these young kings. And so verse 2 is what I wanted. The Lord gave the first message to Jeremiah during the 13th year of the reign of Josiah's son. So while Josiah, the king we just got finished talking about, while he was still king, the Lord began to speak to Jeremiah because he was doing something in all his young men at the time. He was doing something in the young women. He was doing something in the young. And so while one was in power, he began to speak to another about his destiny. Let's go to verse 5. Jeremiah 5:1. If your child's name is in the Bible, let them read what the word of God says about their name. It's empowering. It's empowering. Jeremiah 1:5 says, I knew you. This is the Lord talking to Jeremiah, and he's talking to you too. I knew you before I formed you in your mother's womb. See, it wasn't about your mama and it wasn't about your daddy. The Lord formed you in your mother's womb. The Lord formed you. Before I knew you, I set you apart. And I appointed you as my prophet to the nation. Everything that God has created you to be, he already created you to be that in your mom's womb. And so now, as you live daily, we get to see who God has created us to be in the way that we respond to the situations and circumstances that we encounter daily. Oh, sovereign Lord, I said, I can't speak for you. I'm too young. The Lord replied, don't say I'm too young. The Lord told him, don't say you're too young. Listen, don't let nobody tell you you are too young. Come on. For you must go wherever I send you and say whatever I tell you to say. And don't be afraid of the people. For I will be with you and will protect you. I, the Lord, have spoken. See, it's a young person on here that is listening, and you hear God. And though you are young, you've been doubting it because you don't want to look strange with your friend circle. You don't want to be the one. You don't want to be talked about. But the word of the Lord said, I will be with you. Do not be afraid. Say what it is that God has put on your heart to say. I'm not talking about making up stuff. I'm talking about say what it is, because it may be a friend trying to want to commit suicide. And when you tell them Jesus said he loves you, it's going to be a yoke destroyer. It's going to be the thing that breaks that mindset. They're no longer going to do that thing because now they have heard a word from God. They're just lonely in their heart. Don't be a bully at school. Don't talk about people. You don't know what people are going through. You don't know what stuff that maybe they don't have good clothes like you do, or maybe they don't have nice hair like you have, or maybe they don't look like you look, or maybe they don't go to places that you go to. But don't talk about people because you don't know what people are going through. If you can't say nothing good, don't say nothing at all. Even if your mama talks about people. And even if your daddy talks about people, you don't have to do it. I taught I sat in on a Black History Month teaching, and it was some kindergarten kids, and they asked us to come in and read to them. And it was so amazing because it was about 12 kids sitting around me from all different nationalities and backgrounds. And I could tell what kind of household they were raised in because I could see the fruit of the household's labor. I could see one little girl, and she was so jazzy. I know her mom was at home rolling her neck and blap, 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 because the little girl was talking to me like this and rolling her neck. I said, oh, Lord. One little boy, he was very reserved and very calm and very mild-mannered. Come on. And then we had another little boy, and he was very intellectual, though he was very young. So it's a very interesting thing that our children pick up what's in our household, but at the end of the day, it's your choice. It's your choice. You get to choose. That's why we have free will. You don't get to be disrespectful to your parents. You don't get to do all of that. But you do get to choose to do what is right. To choose to make good choices. To choose to make good decisions. When you are a child of God, you're not going to fit in. You'll always have to do more than the other people are doing. You'll always have to say more. You'll always have to step outside your comfort zone because that's not what God wants for you. So he's not going to let you fit in with the people in the gang. And he's not going to let you fit in with the girls that are gossiping and talking bad. He's not going to let you fit in because he loves you that much. But the thing is, when you don't switch over, you got to switch over and do what it is that God has put in your heart to do. Maybe he's put on your heart to start a youth group after school. Maybe he's put on your heart to start a homeless, feed the homeless in your hometown. Okay, the word of God helps us to understand what's right and what's wrong. Okay, so let's jump back in here. So Jeremiah 1:6, "Oh sovereign Lord," I said, "I can't speak for you. I'm too young." The Lord replied, "Don't say I'm too young. You must go where I send you. You must say whatever I tell you, and don't be afraid of people, for I will be with you and I will protect you. I have spoken. I, the Lord, have spoken." Okay. Then the Lord reached out and touched my mouth and said, "Look, I have put my words in your mouth. Today I appoint you to stand against nations." When you have to take a stand against something, that means you may have to speak against it. So maybe everybody in your friends are saying, maybe that in your friend circle saying, "Oh, it's okay to be gay and it's okay to be homosexual and to be a Christian." And you know that that is not the will of God, for God created man for woman and woman for man. And it's just the truth. It's just the truth. It's just the truth. And so sometimes we have to take a stand for what's right. You don't have to argue. You don't have to yell. You don't have to scream. But what's true is sometimes it's just not sitting at the table with those kids at lunch that are cussing and that are doing things that are not right. Okay. "I have put my word in your mouth. Today I appoint you to stand against nations and kingdoms. Some you must uproot and tear down, destroy, overthrow, and others you must build up and plant." And so God has given an assignment to each one, even though you're young. You might be the one in your classroom that makes sure you pray over lunch with your friends. You get in a circle before you y'all's little table. Y'all hold hands and you read. You say your grace together. That may just be that simple. But don't not do what God has called you to do, because he still talks to young people too. Okay? He still talks to young people. I love something else that's so amazing, y'all. Something else that's so amazing is that as I was preparing for this message, I have to tell you what I heard in the spirit. For those that wake up in the morning and you've been tuning into Makeova Ministry and you're letting the Makeova Ministry play throughout your house while your children are getting ready for school in the morning, the word of the Lord is that blessed are those families who allow the word to set the tone for their children in the mornings. Some are being activated in their spirit and will be filled with the Holy Ghost just by listening to the word of God. Come on. And then the other thing that's so beautiful is that even now the word of God is being hidden in their hearts. The word of God is being hidden in their hearts. The word of the Lord says, "Hide my word in your heart so that you don't sin against me." Thank you, God. Woo, glory. Yes, God. Yes, God. Okay, that's good. That's good. We are the cool kids table. That's good. Very, very true. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Jesus in Luke 2:41-52. He was teaching in the temple. His parents couldn't find him. They was like, "Where are you at?" He was like, "I was about my father's business. I was about my father's business." But he also was obedient to his parents. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for the word on today. And every young person that heard the word today, God, may it be planted deep within their hearts, God. May it be a message that walks with them. Help them to remember they are never by themselves, God, for you are with them, keeping them and carrying them, Lord. Allow your spirit to rest, rule, and abide in and through them. Allow them to be able to go throughout their day today, God, and do what honors you the most. Don't allow them to be disrespectful to their teacher, God. Let them hear the voice of the Lord when they want to rise up. Let them hear the voice of the Lord when they want to be disrespectful, when they don't feel like cleaning their room, and they don't feel like doing the dishes, and they don't feel like being obedient. For your word says, honor thy mother and thy father, and thy days shall be longer upon the face of the earth. Help them to understand yet at a young age. At a young age, help them to understand. Help them to understand yet at a young age, oh great God, that you're with them, covering them, protecting them, that angels walk with them. Lord, you're so amazing, wonderful, mighty are the works of your hands. For you are a good God. You're patient. You're all-knowing and you are all-seeing. Mighty are the works of your hand. We thank you for touching our children. Your word says the seed of the righteous shall be delivered. Thank you, Lord. So our job as parents is to stay in the righteousness of God. But even higher of a call is that they are your children and you are the righteous one. Teach us to parent our children with wisdom and understanding, guidance. Lord, we thank you. We love you. We honor you. You're good to us. You're perfect in all of your ways. You're amazing. Mighty are the works of your hands. We even come as parents with repentant hearts for anything that we have showed them that was not of God, anything that we have done in front of them, any words that we have spoken. For the word of the Lord says we have made the word of God to no effect. And the word says, parents, do not provoke your children to anger. Lord, we thank you. Touch every family on today, God. Touch every family on today, oh great God. Touch them right there where they are. Every mother, strengthen her today, God. Every father, strengthen him today, God, to be the head of the house, the headship of the house, God. Every daughter, every son on today. Help them to understand their true identity. They are who you have called them to be. May they walk into the newness of Christ, understanding that I'm being set apart on purpose. It's no accident that I am set apart. Lord, we bless you. We love you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah and amen. Any young person, any person, but right now we're just talking a lot to our young ones today. Any young person, if you have not accepted Jesus Christ in your heart, and you want to accept him in your heart as your personal Lord and Savior, I want you to repeat this prayer after me. Dear Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Wash me of my sins. Wash me of even the pain of my past. Cleanse me. Make me a new creation. Fill me with your Holy Spirit so that I may do what pleases you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Woo, hallelujah. All of heaven's angels are rejoicing, child of God. All of heaven's angels are rejoicing, child of God. In your heart, maybe you may feel a little tear stream down your face because I feel some hearts that are tender, and that's okay. Because it's a change that is happening in your heart today. I remember my son came out of Bible study one day and he said, Mama, the Lord gave me a new heart. So may the Lord give you a new heart. He said, I will remove that stony heart, that hard-hearted heart, that rebellious heart, and give you a heart of flesh, a heart that feels, a heart that has emotions, a heart that's not selfish. That's not self-centered. A heart that desires to honor God. Hallelujah and amen. Ooh, well, we got put off of TikTok this morning. I got banned. I don't know. I'm sure somebody didn't like something that was being said. And that just lets us know that God's work is going forth, because you will have opposition. That's normal. If you ain't never got no opposition, I don't know what gospel you are preaching. You're going to have opposition sometimes. And that is all right. So I'm excited. Have you registered for the woman's, for our Still Standing Women's Tour? You can register on Eventbrite. Type in the search bar, Still Standing. Come, go ahead and register. We will be in, join us for all 3 days. So I want to make sure it is a 3-day women's revival. Join us for all 3 days if you are available. It will be at 7 p.m. Friday, 7 p.m. Saturday, and 12 noon. We'll have our Sunday morning worship experience. I am expecting God to meet us in Grenada, Mississippi, December 17th, 18th, and 19th. I'm expecting him to show up in a way, glory, that we have never seen before. I'm expecting him to do some amazing and mighty things in our hearts and in our minds and our emotions, honey, in our lives and our children, come on, in our bodies. God, I bless your name. I'm excited about what God is going to do. So please make sure you join us. Go ahead and register. If that's not close to you, don't worry. We'll be doing some traveling, so we'll be hopefully coming to a city near you, all right? Now, if you want to purchase, we have our t-shirts that are for sale for the Still Standing Tour. You can go to prettypraisersboutique.com and you can order your t-shirt for the Still Standing Tour. If you would like to do that, not only are you purchasing your shirt, but you're also sewing into the ministry. Now, and as we get to that, let me give you an opportunity to sew on today. If you would like to sew into this word, this is a very good word to sew into for your children. And young people, I want you to sow today. I want you to sow today. You have to learn to get in the habit of giving to God what is His. Don't let these people get you. Listen, I have been seeing so much stuff on TikTok and other things talking about tithing and people want your money. Baby, you give, when you give with a sincere heart to God, you can't, He don't want, baby, He don't take coins and Cash App. So, you can't give it straight to Him, but when you give to the people of God that are feeding you, that are, that the word of God is transforming you, you're getting deliverance, you're getting healing, you're getting something from the word, and you sow, you give unto that word, and you give with an honest heart, the Lord settles the score with everything else. Okay, the church is not an ATM machine. That's not what the church is. God is not an ATM machine, but the Lord is faithful. And He has said what He has said. And we will not let the world or worldly people or lukewarm Christians or double-minded people of God talk us out of our inheritance. Okay? All right, people of God. All right. I love you all. I pray the word of God encourage you. I pray that it blessed you. I pray that it walks with you throughout the day. Okay? So I will see you all tomorrow right here, same place, same time. Thank you for joining me for a morning makeover. Have a good day on purpose and be encouraged. I am Apostle Julia, and I'm over and out.